Yo, I ain't gonna lie. MTV, EMAs, this is my first time here. I never got an award from MTV before. Years of professionally recording. This is the first time I'm getting an award from MTV. And it feels incredible, yo. Now, if y'all been a part of my journey, y'all know I am going to talk. So be patient with me, please. First thing I want to do is I want to thank my mother. My moms used to watch me listening to one of my heroes' albums all the time, past my 9 o'clock bedtime curfew on a school night. His name is LL Cool J. And I would listen to his albums because the first time that I was motivated to really write a rhyme was because I was being dissed by an MC that I ultimately formed a group with called Leaders of the New School. And I had to come to school the next day and bust his ass because I wanted revenge. My favorite MC, LL Cool J, was the template that I followed when I wrote my first rhyme. And I went back to school the next day and I bust his ass. And that's how we ended up forming a group. I want to salute my brother LL Cool J. I love you, big bro. I salute you, big bro. Everything that I aspired to be, that man planted that seed. And then from there, it led to a lot of other beautiful things. Chuck D, met that brother Chuck D from Public Enemy and Hank Shockley. They gave me my name, Busta Rhymes. I had a trash MC name before Busta Rhymes. But then when I became Busta Rhymes and I started to understand how to embody living that name and understanding that your name ain't just a name. Sometimes a name needs to really be your attribute. I learned how to become the embodiment of Busta Rhymes because I love to bust rhymes for real. And I love hip hop for real. And my mother would see me trying to get on from 13, 14 years old, taking it seriously. And she would bring me good home-cooked Jamaican food dinners to the studio. Make sure that I was nourished and I could be at my best in the studio. And when I was 17 and I finally got my shot, my mother signed my deal because I wasn't old enough to legally sign my own contract. My mother is my best friend. My mother is my hero. And I thank you very much, Ma, for everything that you've done and that you continue to do for me. Spliff Star, you my brother, you my best friend. Ain't no stage in this world that I could touch and have the effect that we have on this planet without you. Scratch it all. I love you so much, my brother, because you complete the trinity between me, you, and Spliff Star. Thank you so much for everything. Bruce Gilmer, thank you so much for honoring me in this way tonight. Mona Scott Young, you are the mother of my career. I love you so much. Beautiful queen and royal empress, Mona Scott Young. Joey Harris, I salute you very much, my brother. Little Sims, thank you for still feeding my soul and inspiring me to be better. Little Sims is probably the only MC that made me go back 3 times to write a verse on a song that I still want y'all to hear. But that's called motivation. That's called not settling, and that's called making each other better. And on that note, I'm going to say this. Yeah, I'm a global icon. I was speaking to a gentleman backstage by the name of David Speed. He's an artist. And he said something that touched my soul tonight, because he teaches art to children. And he said, yo, when I teach these children, I show them my trash art when I first started and how bad my art was. Because you need to help everybody understand that when they see the art that I'm doing now, if you don't show them the process from the foundation and how it evolves when you believe and how it evolves when you dream big and how it evolves when you stay consistent and how it evolves when you are so passionate and failure to you is no longer an option, you can become your best self. So all I'm saying to everybody in this room, they tell us that perfection is unreachable. That shit is a lie. See, the perfection is in the imperfection. We all are the perfection of what we're supposed to be. So be the perfection that you're supposed to be. On that note, I want to thank all of my beautiful children for making me feel like a global icon every day when I come home. I want to thank all of you beautiful fans that have been a part of the journey from the beginning. And everybody that's just now becoming a part of my journey at this point, just know that the ride on this roller coaster is about to get 10 million times more incredible. Because I'm not stopping no time soon. You better believe that you're gonna see me and the generation that I come from become the first James Browns and Mick Jaggers of this rap. Because I am never gonna stop. The blessings don't stop, so we ain't never gonna stop. By the way, I got a new album called Dragon Season. And it's dropping on November 29th, 2024. Happy holidays to everybody. While you celebrate your holidays, make sure you also celebrating Dragon Season. I appreciate y'all. Salute.